This video is sponsored by Envato Elements. Hey everyone, welcome back to the brand new video. Today let's see how to create an organic product slideshow animation in After Effects. It is going to be super easy to create, so without any further ado, let's jump right into After Effects and get started. Let's go. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. Click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition. You can also call it slide 01 because this is gonna be the first slide. I'm gonna use this size 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds long, background color black, hit OK. Now we have to create animated background first, so just go to the rectangle tool. Select this ellipse tool from here, click on fill, set it to solid color, select any color whatever you like, hit OK, click on the stroke and set it to none, and then hold left mouse button, hold control, shift, alt on the keyboard and create this type of circular shape just like that. And then we have to align this circle in the center, so select the move tool, go to align. Click on the align horizontally and vertically and keep the shape in the center, and then we have to set the anchor point in the center, which is very important. So just select the shape layer one, hold control on the keyboard, and this is the pan behind tool, so just double click on this pan behind tool to set the anchor point in the center, and then right click on the shape layer, click on rename, and this is gonna be the circle. Now let's animate the circle, so just go to 1 second and 15 frame. Hit S to bring out the scale property. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Go to very first frame of this animation. Set the scale value 0%. And now we have a linear animation. Select both the keyframe. Hit F9 to easy ease them. You can also right click on that. Go to keyframe assistant and check this option, easy ease. Perfect. Now select both the keyframe. Go to graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that, click on edit a speed graph, highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side and create a nice and a smooth animation. Now you can close the graph editor, close the layer. Now let's apply gradient ramp effect on it, so select the move tool, go to effect and preset and search for gradient ramp. Let's apply this gradient ramp on this circular shape. And here we have to do some setting inside of the effect control. So this is the ramp shape. I'm going to select this option radial ramp. Click on the swap color. And here we have a start and the end point. So I'm going to set the start point in the center of the frame. End point right over here in this corner. Select the end color, maybe the dark orange. Start color, maybe a light color, just like that. Perfect, so here we have the orange gradient color. Now let's create animated text over here. So select the text tool, go to character. Here we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this Bebas New Pro font style, which is an Adobe font style. And of course, you can select any font style, whatever you like. I'm gonna select the style book. And here we have the font size. So I'm gonna set the font size 650 pixel. Character spacing, negative 50. You can turn on this button, all caps, deselect all the layer, click over here and type anything whatever you like, just like that. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, go to align, align horizontally and vertically and keep the text in the center. And now let's set the anchor point in the center of the text, which is very important. So select the text layer, hold control on the keyboard, and this is the pan behind. Just double click on this pan behind and set the anchor point in the center. Now let's animate the text layer. So open the text layer. Here we have the animate. Click on the animate, add the position property. Click on the add button, go to property, add the opacity. And we have to add one more thing. Just click on the add button, go to property, and this is the tracking amount. So here we have position, opacity and the tracking amount. Let's set the Y position value 100, opacity 0% and tracking amount negative 100. Perfect. Open the range selector and here we have the start parameter. So just go to 2 second, set the start value 100. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start property. Go to very first frame of this animation, let's set the start value 0. And now we have this type of text animation. So this is the animation in, let's create animation out. So just go to 3.5 second right over here. Click on the diamond button to create a keyframe on the start property and lock the position as it is. Just go to 1 second forward in time and set the start value 0. Highlight all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it to the left hand side. Highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it to the right hand side. So basically, we will get this type of smooth text animation. Perfect. Before we proceed further with the tutorial, I just want to take a minute and talk about today's sponsor, Envato Elements. Design better video faster with Envato Elements. Get unlimited downloads of beautiful and ready-to-use templates for digital projects and create more with premium design assets, video templates, mockups, fonts, presentations, photos, audio files, and more. All with commercial licenses for extra peace of mind. Envato Elements will enhance any project while saving your time, efforts, and money. Get unlimited downloads with Envato Elements and start creating today. All the links given in the description, just check it out. And now we have to add some animated leaf over here. Select the Move tool, go to Project window. Right click on that, go to Import file and select this leaf PNG file. You can use any leaf PNG file or any organic product such as orange or lemon, whatever you like. You can download these files from the link given in the description. You can also download the complete project file and you will get all the PNG file inside of it. Once you have downloaded and select the files, click on Import. And now let's create a separate composition for the leaf. So simply drag and drop the leaf PNG on this little composition icon over here and create a separate composition by using this leaf. And now just go to slide 1 and here we have the leaf composition. So let's drag and drop inside of this main composition. Hit S to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it down a bit and fit the leaf just like that. You can set the scale value 65%. Go to very first frame of this animation. Select the leaf, hit R to bring out the rotation. Let's set the rotation value -3°. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the rotation property. Go to the end of this animation, set the rotation value 3. Now we have a movement on the leaves, as you can see. After that, we have to create separate composition for the organic product. So just go to composition, take a new composition, and this is gonna be 1080 by 1080 composition. And let's call it fruits. Leave the other setting as it is, hit OK. Now let's drag and drop the organic product inside of this fruit composition. Hit S to bring out the scale property and scale it up just a little bit. Perfect. Now just go to slide 01, drag and drop the fruits composition inside of the main composition. Hit S to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it down and set the size something around 70% or maybe 65. 70% is good. And after that, we have to animate the fruit. So what we have to do, just go to 2 seconds, hit R to bring out the rotation property. Let's set the rotation 5°. And turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the rotation property. Go to very first frame of this animation and let's set the rotation something around -15°. Perfect. So we will get this type of smooth rotation and then just go to 3.5 seconds. Let's set the rotation 10°. Just go to 1 second forward in time and set the rotation 20°. So basically we will get this type of smooth rotation animation. Perfect. Highlight all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point, drag it on the left hand side, highlight this point and drag it on the right hand side. So basically we will get this type of animation. Perfect. Now you can close the graph editor, close the layer, and here we have this type of animation. After that, we have to apply drop shadow effect on this fruit. So select the fruit, go to effect and preset and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect. Let's apply this on the fruit layer. And here we have the softness. Let's set the value 100, distance 0, and set the opacity something around 25%. Or you can also increase the softness and set it to 200%. Now you can see before and after, it's looking perfect. And after that, we have to select the background color according to the product. So select the circle, go to the effect control, and here we have the start and end color. So pick this color picker and pick any color from the product and create the gradient color according to the product color. Perfect. And finally, we have to animate the camera. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new camera. Let's call it camera and set the preset 50 mm, hit OK. And then we have to create a null object. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new null object. And this is gonna be the controller. So I'm gonna call it controller. Select the camera, click on the toggle switches, and this is the pick whip. So attach this pick whip with this controller. And now you can control the camera with the controller. After that, we have to turn on the 3D button. So click on the toggle switches, and this is the 3D button. Turn on the 3D button for all the layers, and then select these four layers. Hit P on the keyboard to bring out the position property. Leave the circle as it is. And this is the text layer. So I'm gonna set the Z position value for the text -500. For the leaf, set it to -1000. And for the fruit composition, I'm gonna set the value -1500. Perfect. Now we have to fit the scale. So select these three layers, hit H to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it down and set the size something around 90%. And this is the leaf. Let's set the size 40% or 42% maybe. And this is the size for fruits. Let's down the size and set the value something around 33%. Perfect. Now you can close all the layers. Select the controller, hit P to bring out the position property. Just go to 2 seconds. Here we have the Y position value. So click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the position property. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the position of the camera something like this. And then just go to 3.5 seconds. Click on the diamond button to create a keyframe and lock the position as it is. Go to 1 second forward in time. Let's set the position right over here. Set the value 1300 in Y direction. Highlight all the keyframes. Hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. Highlight this point. Hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side. And do the same thing. Hold this point and drag it to the right hand side. Perfect. Now you can close the graph editor. And here we have something like this. Perfect. Now just go to 3.5 seconds. Select the background. Hold Ctrl Shift D and split the layer. Select the second layer and turn off the 3D button. Now you will get this type of complete background at the end of this animation. Perfect. So this is the first slide. Let me show you how you can create the multiple slides. So it's very simple. Let's go to project window, create a new folder, and this is going to be the slide 01. You can move all the layers and the composition inside of the slide 01 folder, and then you can save the project. So just go to file and click on save as. Select your location. You can set a name for the project. Click on save, and let's import the same project file inside of the project window. So just right click on the project window, go to import file and select the AEP file. Click on import, open the folder, and here we have the slide 01. Right click on that, click on rename, and this is going to be the second slide. I'm going to call it slide 02, open it up, and here we have the main composition. So right click on that, click on rename, and this is going to be the slide 02. Perfect. Now you can drag and drop the slide 02 outside of this fruit tutorial composition. Now you can delete the folder, and here we have the first slide and the second slide. We have to create a separate composition for that. So just go to composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be the render comp. Duration, make it 10 seconds for two different slides. You can set the size 1920 by 1080, hit OK. And then let's import the first slide first inside of the render composition, just like that. And then you can drag and drop the second slide into this render composition. Now let's overlap the composition for 1 second. Just go to 4 second and move the second composition right over here. And now we will get this type of animation. Now let's change the color of the second composition and the product. So open the slide 02. Here we have to replace the product. So open the fruits composition. Now let's import another product. So this is the lemon. Let's import it. Let's drag and drop the lemon inside of this fruit composition. Select the second product. Let's increase the size and fit the image inside of this composition. And here we have to change the text just like that. And finally, we have to change the color. So just delete the second circle and stretch the first layer just like that. After that, select the circle, go to effect control. And here we have to pick the color according to the product. So pick the first color, something like this. Second color from here. Now it's looking like this. And then you can go to the render composition. And here we have the first slide and the second slide. It is looking absolutely perfect, as you can see. And now you can turn on the motion blur and you can see the result. And then we have to do one more thing. You can remove this effect. So just open this second composition, just go to 3.5 second, select the circle, hold Ctrl Shift D and split the layer. Now select the second layer and turn off the 3D button. And now we have the background, something like this. Then just go to the render composition and you can see the background here. And by using this technique, you can create multiple slides. And now let's take a look. Alright, it is looking pretty amazing, right? So that is the wrap for today. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and got the value from it. If you did, then please subscribe to this channel, like this video to appreciate my hard work, and also comment below this video if you have any question or thoughts. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.